Hello friends, welcome to one more video on NISM certification examination. This time I am going to cover commodity derivative certification examination in the video. The idea behind making this video is to take you through 30 questions related to one specific chapter. The questions have been designed in such a way that they cover the entire concepts discussed in this particular chapter. It is about chapter 6, which is related to trading mechanism. As you know that commodities are traded in different exchanges, and there are commodity derivatives products also available. So this particular chapter, which is chapter 6, deals with the trading mechanism. Let me take you through the questions one by one. So the first question is, which of the following member of commodity exchange cannot trade? So on commodity exchanges, you have different types of members. You have trading members who trade for themselves as well as for their clients. You have self-clearing member who not only trade but also clear their own trades. But it is the professional clearing members who cannot actually trade. They only carry out clearing and settlement. So the answer for this question is C. I am repeating, it is C. With this, I move on to the second question, which is about one key concept related to clearing corporation. Clearing corporation, as you would know, is a key entity apart from stock exchange, which helps in the trading mechanism on the exchanges. So which of the following is not true about role of clearing corporation? Please note that the question is asking about, out of the four statements, which statement is not true? If you look at it, the first statement is, clearing corporation's main role is to carry out settlements of trade executed on stock exchange platform, which is absolutely correct. Clearing corporations also guarantee settlement. They actually stand between buyer and seller, and if either of the two party default, it is the clearing corporation which ensures that the transaction still settles. Clearing corporation is an entity that is different from exchange. They are a separate entity, completely separate entity. So the answer for this is that clearing corporation is responsible for granting trading rights to various types of members of exchange. This particular option is incorrect, and that's why the answer is D. Now I move on to question number 3. Which of the following methods is used for order matching in a screen-based trading system? So commodity trading is a screen-based trading, and it uses a method which is called as price time priority, which means the first preference is always given to the price in terms of storing the order. And if two prices are same, either on the buy side or on the sell side, then the first priority is given to the time. So obviously the answer for this question is A, which is price time priority. We don't have time price priority concept, neither we have FIFO or last in first out concept. The most important aspect in order storing is the price. We move on to the fourth question, where you have to find out to fill in the blanks. Okay, so when orders are matched for trade, we have to understand that the highest buy price and the lowest sell price are actually used for matching the order, which means in the trading system, on the top in the buy side of the quote, highest buy quote comes, because we know that if you are a buyer and if you are quoting the highest price, you will get the first priority, and if you are the seller and you are quoting the lowest price, you will get the first priority. So answer for this particular question is obviously B, which is highest buy and the lowest sell price. Let us move on to question number 5, which is again about being one option being not true. So which of the following is not true in case of buy side of the future contract? So in futures contract, we have buy side and the sell side. So there are some buyers and there are some sellers. So this particular question will be evaluated from the buyer's perspective. So let us look at each of the option. The buyer needs to pay an upfront initial margin to take a long position in commodity future market, which is correct. Which means if you want to transact in commodities futures market, and if you are a buyer, you have to pay a margin. Long position is exposed to mark to market if kept open. Obviously, every day your gains and losses will be calculated, and that is what we are trying to understand in context of mark to market. Open long positions will result in taking physical delivery, and cash settlement is not allowed. No, this particular option is incorrect, because you can take physical delivery, or you may not take physical delivery, and cash settlement is very much possible. So we are not even evaluating the fourth option, which anyway is that buyer, if desired, can square off his position during the same day or during the period of contract, which is correct. So the option C becomes incorrect. Let us move on to question number 6. Which of the following type or types of orders are not allowed in algo trading? So when you do algo trading, remember, you cannot place a market order or you cannot place a limit or cancel order. So the right option is both A and B, which makes the correct answer to be D. So I hope till now you are completely aligned with the questions which I have discussed. I have shared my email ID at the end. So if you have any doubts, you can write on that email ID. Next question is the 7th one, and that is, which of the following entities decide base price when a new futures contract is made available for trading? So the moment a new futures contract is made available for trading, there is a base price which needs to be determined to identify the price of that particular contract which is going to be traded for the first time. The market regulator does not decide it, market forces do not decide it, nor is this the responsibility of clearing corporation. So automatically the answer becomes A, which is commodity exchanges. Let us move quickly to question number 8. Which of the following is used to calculate mark to market gain or loss? So mark to market gain or loss is calculated based on the daily settlement price. It is not calculated on final settlement price, because that is the end of the transaction life cycle, and then the final gain or losses are calculated. And due date rate is the similar thing like final settlement price. So the answer would be C. Now we move on to question number 9, which is only about true and or false. So high frequency trading is part of algorithm trading. Is this true or is this false? Absolutely true. This takes us to answer A. So algorithm trading and high frequency trading are interlinked. In fact, high frequency trading is a subset of algorithmic trading. We move to question number 10, and I'm moving slightly faster so that you can get to see more and more questions in less time. Which of the below mentioned is an odd one out, which means out of the four, find out one which is not in sync. So we have daily price range, daily price limit, daily settlement price, and circuit filters. So basically A, B, and C are the same thing. I mean, it's like three names for the same thing. So the odd one out becomes D in this particular case. So now we have completed 10. We move on to the 11th one. Which of the following is not a delivery option available in the commodity market? So when you trade in commodity market, you have an option to deliver the underlying. So a compulsory delivery, that could be one of the options, which means you have to compulsorily deliver. Both option and the seller's option are also available. What is not available, in fact, from these options, all since everything is available, we would say that the answer is D, which is all of the above are delivery options. Now we move on to question number 12, which is related to initial margin and extreme loss margin. So initial margin and extreme loss margin are normally based on VAR, which is value at risk, calculated on price volatility considering holding period of not 1 day, not 30 days, not 365 days, but 2 days. So the answer becomes B here. Next question is the 13th one, and that's more of a knowledge-based question like many of my questions earlier. How many times is open position limit at member level compared to client level typically? Which means, if you know, what is it that is allowed as an open position at member level compared to the client level? So clients will definitely have lesser limits and members will have higher limits. So what is that relationship? That relationship is 10 times. So the option or the answer here becomes B. The 14th question is, which of the following is not required characteristics as far as the introduction of a new commodity for futures trading is concerned? So the moment a new commodity is introduced in the future segment, what should be the minimum requirement and which one does not fit into that requirement category is what is being discussed in this question. So first option, commodities should have a suitable demand and supply condition, which is very much required. Prices should be volatile to necessitate hedging through derivatives. You know, this is a requirement, because if prices are more or less stable or fixed, there would be no interest in derivatives contract. The commodity should be under substantial control of government regulation. No. In fact, if government regulation is there, then the commodity trading cannot be done because government will decide most of the characteristics related to the price, as a result of which market will have very limited call to take. So the option would be C here. Okay. We move on to question number 15. Which of the below mentioned option describes minimum price movement in terms of change in price or change in quotation for an order? So it's like, you know, what is the minimum movement that can happen in the price? I mean, if the price is 140, what could be the minimum movement from 140? Can it become 141 straight away, or it can become 139? So there would be a minimum gap which is permitted, and that is called as the tick size. The answer has already been revealed to you. We move on to the next question, which is 16th one. Which of the following is a category A modification in commodity futures contract? So in commodity future contract, we can do various modifications in the contract specification. When it comes to the commodity A, category A, apologies, then tick size is something which does not fall under category A. Expiry date, trading unit, and delivery unit fall under category A modification. We move on to question 17. Which of the following is the minimum quantity which will go for trading or delivery in a commodity contract? Which means how much minimum can you trade for? And the answer is very easy. That's why I'm moving slightly quickly. It is lot size. So let us now move on to question number 18. Which of the following does not fall under category C modification? So there are many modifications which fall out. Obviously, out of 4, 3 would fall into that. So which does not fall? So the answer is expiry date. So tender period, due date rate, contract launch calendar, all three are part of category C modification, but expiry date is not part of that. Now question number 19. Which of the following order is generally placed after entering into a trade? So once you have done the trade, what kind of order can you place? So limit order, market order, and immediate or cancel order can be placed before the trade has been placed into the system. So what is left out is the stop loss order. So after you have placed your order, you can place a stop loss order to reduce your risk or to mitigate the risk that you may be facing. Let us move on to question number 20. For a buyer, if you are a buyer, what does limit order mean for me? So mean for you. So limit order is an order where you can prescribe or you can place your own price, that this is the price at which I want to buy a particular stock or a particular commodity. Okay, so for a buyer, the limit order generally means below the ongoing asking price. So you know, since you are a buyer, you are not happy with the current price, so you will quote the lower price. And for a seller, the limit order means, you know, from the seller's perspective, it would be above the bid price, which means he has to ensure that he places an order, okay, which is above the current bid price, okay, so that he can get the transaction done, right? Now, having said this, let us move to question 21. Which of the following is not a time-related order? So we have two types of order which are placed, price-related order and time-related order. So basically, good till cancel, good till valid, immediate or cancel, these three are time-related order, and stop-loss order is a price-related order. So we have completed 21 questions by now. This takes us to 22nd question. Which of the following is a measure and indicator of relative liquidity? Which means if you want to find out liquidity position in the market, what you do is that you typically look at the bid-ask spread. How much is the bid? What is the ask? What is the buy price? Best buy price? What is the best sell price? And how do you figure it out? You figure it out through a measure which is called as impact cost. So the answer here would be A. Now we move on to question number 23, which is more about charges, transaction charges. Which of the following does not fall under statutory charges, which means this is not levied as per the law as far as trading in commodities is concerned? This is a very easy one. Commodity transaction tax, goods and service tax, stamp duty, all those are as per the statute. And brokerage is something which will be charged by the broker as per the service that the broker provides. So it may vary, but first three would be a fixed percentage. So what is margin money and when it is released? The question is about that. So margin money is released only on the expiry of the contract? No, that's unfair answer, because margin can be withdrawn even before expiry, only when the open position is squared of no. That would also be not the right answer. So our right answer would be either on the expiry of the contract, which is C, or when the open position is squared of, whichever is earlier. So whichever happens earlier, that would be the answer as per the choices given. We move on to question number 25 quickly. Which of the following order has the shortest time duration, which means this order stays for the shortest period in the system? And obviously the answer here would be immediate or cancel, because immediate and cancel order, immediate or cancel order means by nature that either it will be immediately executed or it will get cancelled. Question number 26. Which of the following describes total number of long or short positions, which means from the market perspective, how many long or how many short positions we have got? That is what is called as the open interest. So the answer here is A, not open position, now traded quantity. It is the open interest. Okay, question number 27. We know there are many alternative investment funds which are registered with SEBI, different categories. So which of the following type of AIF, which is alternative investment fund, is allowed to participate in commodity derivative by SEBI? The answer is AIF 3. So 1 and 2 are not allowed, but 3 is allowed. Question number 28. Introduction of futures trading on new commodities or withdrawal of futures trading on specific commodity require prior approval of SEBI. Earlier, this power used to be there with FMC. Now the power has moved on to SEBI. Now, next question, and we are left with only two. In which of the below mentioned order type, price will adjust based on settings that the trader set on the initiation of the trade? So we have certain trades in which the price keeps on getting adjusted. Especially this trade, this type of trade is called as the trailing stop loss order. Okay, because when the market price goes up and you have put a stop loss order, the stop loss order amount will automatically change with the change in the market price. So the answer would be B. And we move on to question number 30, which is the last one. Which of the following is not true for algo trading? So in this particular case, as we have already seen in one of the questions, we will straight away move to the option D, because A, B and C are correct. So in algo trades, immediate or cancel and market orders are allowed. If you recollect, we had already seen that it is not allowed. So that's make the answer as D. Now we have covered 30 questions in a span of around 18 minutes. That means we hardly give some time to these questions, because you can read yourself, understand yourself, and if you do not understand, still there is an option open. What is the option? Write to healthofmywealth@gmail.com. So that's where you will write. The spelling is slightly wrong, so please take care of it. healthofmywealth@gmail.com. This ends this particular video. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for your time, and please do not forget to subscribe my channel and like this video.